Hey everyone, welcome back to Wes Knows Tech News and Reviews. Today we're going to be doing a comprehensive and utter complete test of the GTR2E, the Amazfit GTR2E. So without further ado, let's get into it.
If you are new to Wes Knows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way.
We can be talking about the specs all day long, because the Amazfit GTR2E is a great watch. It's a smartwatch that's basically a shortcut, a slightly shortcut version of the Amazfit GTR2. It looks stunning. It looks amazing. Well, let's be honest. 1.39-inch AMOLED display with a 326 ppi just can't look that bad, as well as the borderless display. It's got 90 sport modes, and 6 of these are actually auto-detected. Now, that's just amazing. There's inbuilt GPS, there's voice control to keep you happy, Alexa is coming via an OTA update anytime soon now. You get so many apps, so much features and functionality, such as continuous heart rate monitoring, continuous stress monitoring. You have your on-demand or spot SpO2 readings. As well as that, you've got your 3 sleep stages, so your deep, your light, and REM sleep. As well as that, it actually records naps, as long as they're over 20 minutes. On top of that, you get PI, the Personal Activity Index. And we all know about that. Just keep the value above 100 points, and statistically speaking, you're 25% less prone to getting heart disease. I can talk about that display for another day, because it's just amazing. 326 ppi, on top of that, you got the ambient light sensor, so you are going to get auto brightness. You can do always on display. You've got so many faces that you can download in the Zep app, and if you're not happy with any of them, then of course you do have the choice of actually uploading a picture from your smartphone to your watch face. Easy as pie. And another thing with Amazfit smartwatches, it doesn't matter if you're using an iOS device as an iPhone or you're using an Android phone, and that can be anything from Samsung to Huawei to Xiaomi, it doesn't matter. So that's really quite good. Now, when the GTR2E has just been delivered to me, I've actually done an intro to the GTR2E and I've put it up against the GTR2. So if you haven't seen that review, I'm just gonna have it up in the cards above me right now. So have a look at that, just to get a feeling of what the GTR2E. And in that video, I actually show that the difference is so minuscule, so tiny between the two watches. Yes, the GTR2, the flagship, it does have a slightly better screen. The actual glass is 3D instead of the 2.5D. I actually explain the differences there. The GTR2 also has inbuilt storage for music. The GTR2E does not have that. But the GTR2E does have a temperature gauge. It looks just like it. It's only a little bit thicker by 0.1 millimeters, so I doubt you're gonna notice that. And of course, it's slightly heavier by 0.5 grams, so that's not major. But anyway, that's the GTR2E, and I've actually got it right here. So there we go. This beast right here, that's what we're going to be testing today. This is a comprehensive test where we are testing resting heart rate, active heart rate, as well as the GPS. So without further ado, let's get into it. So let's start with the accuracy of the GPS. So we can see from the GPX app, as well as from the Polar Beat app, that I've been out walking for 34 and a half minutes and I've covered a distance of 3.08 kilometers. Now let's take a look at what the GTR2E actually recorded on its inbuilt GPS. And here we also see that the walking time or the workout time was 34 and a half minutes, but the distance registered was 3.19 kilometers. So we are off by about 110 meters or about 3%. For the resting heart rate, we're going to be checking what the optical heart rate sensor on the GTR2E has actually measured, and we're going to be putting that against the O2 ring from Wellu. So that O2 ring is actually medical grade, so it's a continuous SpO2 as well as heart rate monitor. And here it is. So the SpO2 ring has actually registered 62 beats per minute as the average resting heart rate over the night. Now the GTR2E has actually registered 63 beats per minute. the difference is minuscule. It's tiny, it's almost non-existent. And now I think we're ready to get into the most interesting and exciting bit of this accuracy test. We're going to be looking at the active heart rate as tracked by the optical heart rate sensor on the GTR-2E and the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. So let's quickly look at what the Polar H10 has actually registered. So it picked up the average heart rate of 146 beats per minute, while the max heart rate was registered at 167 beats per minute. The GTR-2E has actually picked up the average heart rate at 138 beats per minute, giving us a variance of 8 beats per minute or 5.5%. So that's an underestimation of 5.5%. Now, the max heart rate was also underestimated by 4 beats per minute or 2.4%. If we look at the chart, we can see where the problem area is. So about 3-4 minutes into the workout, we can see that the peak just sort of drops down. And while the ECG chest strap is picking up quite high activity, where my heart rate is up above 140 beats per minute, the GTR-2E is just reducing the heart rate and it drops down all the way to 120 beats per minute. And we can see that this underestimation actually lasts for about 4 minutes. Then it does pick up, but once again, one of the peaks where we can actually see the 167 beats per minute being reached by the ECG chest strap, that's not registered. It's cut off by the GTR-2E. Then we go down to the trough. The trough seems to be fine. It does pick it up. We can see an obvious lag in the pickup of the heart rate. And in the last 3 minutes or so of the workout, the GTR-2E is doing a relatively good tracing of the ECG chest strap. Overall, problem areas. And this is something that we've picked up on another model from Amazfit, the GTS-2E. If you recall, it also undercuts and underestimates the peaks of your heart rate. I would say the GTR-2E does perform slightly better than the GTS-2E, but still it's way worse than the GTR or the GTS-2 Mini. And by the way, the GTS-2 Mini, wow, we love that optical heart rate sensor. In basically every test and comparisons against Garmin, Fitbit, Samsung, it just kills them. Like, the GTS-2 Mini heart rate sensor is amazing. But anyway, back to the GTR-2E. It's a great watch. It does show good potential. If we talk about the other metrics like GPS, sleep accuracy, as well as resting heart rate, I think that the GTR-2E actually performed really well. We can see that there are no problems. Again, things are happening when we are working out. The peaks are being underestimated. And that's a slight problem. I don't think it's major, but it's there. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you did find this accuracy test useful, then drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, then please hit the subscribe button below the video, and I'll see you in the next one.